Hello, and welcome to hopefully the first in many episodes of Best Community Creations and Scrap Mechanic, or something like that. Now, I absolutely love taking a look at what people have made for Scrap Mechanic because people are just geniuses. I'm so happy when I can make a wheel spin the right way, but when I see what other people are capable of, well, I can't do the same. I haven't seen these yet. I've selected a few that I thought looked cool, so you'll be looking at them fresh with me. Some of them might not work the way they're supposed to, and some of them might be amazing, but we'll have a look anyway. So we've got a few buggies, a few rock climbers, and even a house to take a look at today. Some of these look fantastic, but the first one I want to have a look at is this quad bike and trailer made by someone called Lord Payne. Now, the cool thing about this is that it should fit in the back another ATV, so let's just have a little look. Made by the same fellow. How do we open this? Okay, so. Oh, what have I done? Range? What does that mean? I've never seen that before. Anyway, there we go. So number one opens and closes it. Oh, look at that! Lights flashing. That's pretty distracting. Oh, nice forward facing lights. Okay, I think that's about it. So we'll open up the back here. And we'll take this one for a little ride. Oh, it's got nice easy action on it. And line it up. Oh no, I don't think it's going to fit in. Oh, it does. Oh, look at that. Nope, okay. So we probably damaged the paintwork on this. Oh, look at that. Oh, absolutely perfect. Okay. And close it up. Ah, oh, look at that. Alright, well that's simple. Now let's see, I guess you'd want to take this off-road, so let's see if we can climb to the top of this hill, although I doubt it's going to have the strength. No, not even close. No, I don't think we're going to make it up there. Maybe this way. Okay, maybe we need more speed. I'll take a run up. Okay, we've got a little bit of distance now. I'll take a run up. Surely we can get up this. Nope, slowing already. Nope, not a chance. Okay, I wonder if just an ATV, or just a quad bike could do it. Oh, got to open up. Put our hazards on just in case anybody comes along and is wondering, doesn't see us and crashes into us. That'd be no good. Okay, so why is it not getting... What are you doing? There we go. Okay then. Easy does it. Easy. Easy does it. There we go. Whoa! Oh, okay, this is a bit more powerful now. Okay, pretty... Look at his head! Head, it's flopping around everywhere. Oh, I love the weird ragdoll physics in this game. Okay, so this is a little bit slippy but pretty powerful little hill climber. It's quite hard to control, wants to throw the back out a lot, but gets up there, lifts up a little bit. But the next thing I want to look at is a crane. This crane. Now, I've played on a few cranes before and they've not worked so brilliantly, but this one looks really detailed, so let's take a look at what this can do. Okay, some nice action. Oh, look at that, look at the way the wheels turn. Isn't that fantastic? Oh, that's beautiful. Okay, so we'll see what we can do. Okay, so one turns it left, two right, three down, four up, and five, the second half, six down, and seven closes. Wow, that's cool. It won't open up again. I'm not sure. I think I may have broken this now. There we go. Okay, right. So we need to build some things to move. Let's see if we can fill a bucket with scrap. Well, that's just spiffy, isn't it? Look at that. beautiful, beautiful yellow skip. Now we're all very legitimate and realistic looking. So let's go get in this. Oh, I don't know how to get in. There you go. Climb up. Okay, so I think we're in a position where we can reach both scrap and skip. Now, I can't remember. There's so many controls for this. It's hard to actually remember which one does which. But I think we'll get there. Okay, so first job is to align this. Now, I was never very good at those machines that you pick toys up and try and... Oh, look at it, it's moving down by itself. Well, look at that. Okay, then. So, it's over the top, and it's maybe five, no. Okay, six. Nope. Seven. There we go. Oh, nice. Oh, it's worked. Right, and now, did we actually grab anything? I'm about to pick this up. There we go. Okay. We've got one object. All right. Well, it's better than none. So, easy does it. And I think it's eight to let go. Yes. Look at that. Perfect. Okay, then. Let's try this again. There we go. And lift. Lift, 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 which is lift? There we go. And back round. And eight to drop, I think. There we go. So you've got to turn it off first. You've got to press seven again before you can press eight, because it's constantly trying to close. It's not very good, would it? Maybe a tea break. We'll go for a tea and biscuit break after we've filled the skip. And onto the plastering. What? Right, I'm just whacking buttons at random here. I can't seem to remember which ones do which. All right, and seven... See, we've got a couple of things there, I think, maybe. No, that one's just going to fall out as soon as we move. Okay, well, we'll take that. I'm happy with that. Got the biggest piece anyway. And... Oh, this is fantastic. Look at that. Yeah, when I was a little kid, I absolutely loved toy diggers. Absolutely brilliant. This is so well done. Ah, look at that. You know, I am extremely impressed with this. What an absolutely beautiful creation, and it looks so good as well. Look at that. So you've got the engines, and then you've got the wires going to the mechanics for this, and you've got the pistons. Now, are these pistons real? Have we actually got pistons in Scrap Mechanic, or is this just... Wow. Oh, brilliant. Anyway, oh, it'd be good if Scrap Mechanic did real pistons, though, but people could do a lot with that. Okay, next up, I think we're going to try a little bit of rock climbing, and we have a differential buggy made by, Sales, something like that. So there's a lot of controls here. One to lock and unlock the differential on both axles, an automatic lock and unlock, separated if needed. Three lights, additional headlights, turn signal left, turn signal right, nice little... feature there. Okay then, so let's have a little go at this. Wow, it's bigger than I thought it was going to be. So how the hell people have made a different... Look at that. Wow. Wow. Some detail. I'll tell you what, people are just geniuses, aren't they? So one. Oh, look at that. It's quite simple, really. Let's see it unlock as we're driving. I think differential basically means it allows different types of torque on each wheel, so really good for off-roading and such, rock climbing maybe. And it's going very slow, and I think that means it's got a hell of a lot of torque on these wheels. So let's just try it on a simple hill first of all and see if it struggles at all. I've got the differential locked at the moment, and it is no problem whatsoever. Just... didn't even pause to go up that hill. Absolutely fantastic. Feels very solid. Beautiful design. Complicated design. Looks like something from Jurassic Park. Absolutely beautiful. Let's try it up something a little bit steeper, see if it struggles. Oh, look at that. not even a slightest bit of protest. Now, it doesn't have, it's not very deep along the middle, and it doesn't really have that much suspension, it seems. So I think it will struggle trying to get up. We need to find a really nice point with the rocks that aren't too deep, because I don't think we'll get up the initial lip of most of these rocks. But this rock here looks like it comes down pretty low, so we'll try this first. So let's try getting up this. Oh, got absolutely no problem whatsoever. I don't want to drop down that because I think I'd just roll over. So we'll reverse up and see if we can find another place to take this. Cool, let's try out this. Now this is pretty steep just straight away, so we'll have a little go at this. Oh, no problem. Wow. So much torque on this. Even going downhill, it doesn't speed up. It's nice and steady going downhill as well. You know, you'd think it would just lose control and start going really fast, but look at this. Nice and steady, nice and easy. This is an absolute brute. Now, we just need to find some rocks that give a nice gentle slope, because I think most rocks would just get stuck on the differential sticking out the bottom there. See, it's just getting the initial tyres on that rock there. Oh, it's struggling a bit. Doesn't seem to want to get that grip. But, wow. Well, it's made it, yeah. I mean, can't complain about that. A little bit of loss of traction there, but the engine certainly didn't struggle. And nice and slow. Even coming off there, doesn't want to tip over. Feels solid and firmly placed on the floor. Okay, now let's give this a go. Oh, we're on. And we're up. Pretty easy. See if we can work our way across here. Ah, there's a really sticky out point there that I think will get jammed. No, no, oh! Wow, that was really impressive. I didn't think it'd make it this far. Let's see if we can get up this next bit. No, I don't think it will do. It's slipping. It's very steep. No, no, no! Oh, very close though. Very close. I think we could actually do that. I think this deserves to be given another chance at this, because it is just a fantastic creation. I couldn't dream of making something this complicated. No, can we just get over that lip? Come on! So close! Come on, it's just that back wheel. If we get that back wheel over, I think we might be able to make this. Come on. No, I think we need just a little bit of help with the thrust there. Oh, wait a second. Spoke too soon. Oh no, come on. So close. Ugh. No, it's just not getting the traction to get up there. And honestly, I mean, look at that. It's almost vertical, so I'm really not surprised. I don't think anything without thrusters would be able to do that, to be fair. You know, it's just missing a little bit of traction on them tyres. Otherwise, it definitely has got the power. It's just not getting the traction. So, we'll take the easy route down. There we go. All right, then. Well, I think we took that through its paces. I like the way it parks very neatly. And I'm thoroughly impressed with that. Absolutely brilliant creation. So, the next one is going to be another rock climber, and it's by Lord Payne. I think we've already played one by Lord Payne. Now this one's emphasis is much more on its suspension, which and its huge wheels obviously might give it a bit more of an advantage on the rock climbing. So let's jump straight on here. It's a six wheeler, turns from both the back and the front. Oh, it's a lot faster than the last one. Now we're going to take it up the same way to see comparatively how well it does to the more realistic buggy. Now, no, it straight away it struggles to get up there. It's a little bit too hyper, a little bit too fast. The speed gives it a good advantage, but definitely wants to lift up at the front, and I think that's just too steep and a little bit too fast for that very finicky little area. But it's got a lot more clearance on the bottom, so that gives it an advantage getting up onto initial rocks straight away. Just like this. Right up in there. Now that back suspension, oh, it's fantastic. Look at that. It's very complicated, the way it moves. I love the way the wheels, how high the wheels can come up there. No problem going over logs and stuff like that, which I think the other one would struggle because of the clearance. This has obviously got much larger wheels. Yeah, and that suspension squeaking away is fantastic as well. Now let's take it over a few smaller rocks and no, it really wants to turn over. It's actually hard to keep. It's hard to keep upright. Look at that. Lovely action on that suspension. And like, such a high clearance on there that you can even sit on such pointy rocks and all wheels touching. Oh, look at that wheel there. Look at that. That suspension is such a high, what would you call it? A high throw on it. Not a problem at all. Another buggy we've got is a dune buggy by Cocoa Cosi. I don't quite know, but this one's a dune buggy and has city mode. Suspensions aren't so smooth anymore. Extra boost, that's nice. And open the hatch to get out easier. And a horn, they're lovely. So, okay, the suspension locks up a bit. That's nice. Really nice action there. And I think that's the engine speeding up, number two. Open the roof. Right, okay, so the roof doesn't... Okay, I thought the roof wasn't going to close again there for a moment. And we have a horn, that's nice. Wow, look at that. Okay, as soon as I turn, that suspension's wild. That's brilliant, the whole chassis turns. It's the wiggliest car I've ever seen. Okay, I love that. So what happens if we lock it? It's almost a little bit of movement, but not as much. Obviously not as much clearance on this one, and the wobbliness does concern me a little bit. It might just throw me off the top of the rocks. But, well, it's having no problem getting over here. Ah, see, there we go. It's touching at the bottom of the, on the rock, lifting the wheels off the actual rock, causes some trouble. And it likes to turn over a bit too easily. This is pretty steep. We'll give this a go. Okay, yeah. So struggling to get up here, so we use the boost. Not really. Oh, here it is. Maybe a little bit. Okay, and we let go of the boost. Yeah, so it does help, but maybe this is just a little bit too steep. So we'll try here instead. And boost. Yeah, it really does help. Yeah, it really does work. Look at the suspension going wild, and the cab itself is playing pretty much still. It looks fantastic. See, now this is very bumpy ground, and it is ridiculously stable. I mean, that the wheels are going everywhere, the suspension's going crazy, but the stabilization effect that it has is just looks brilliant. Look at that. On the flat. You know, just really keeps control of the movement of this. Okay, so it's not deep enough to hit rocks like that. Oh, yeah. Okay, this is wonderful. So impressive. So easy to drive. Yeah, so this is a really good buggy for getting about. If you need to cross the map in a short amount of time without tipping overloads, then this is a really good creation for just that purpose. I am a bit apprehensive about this one. The next one is going to be a roller coaster. I've never downloaded a creation like this before, or any kind of roller coaster type creation or buggy on rails. I tried to make a few myself and they never worked very well, but this is by Chris. And he says, get ready for a crazy ride. Now, I don't even know if this is going to run very well. It's a huge creation. Okay. We got nothing then, so I'll give that another go. Okay, so this isn't loading in at all, so we might have to load this into the flat environment. Okay, so it's worked this time. Didn't seem to like the terrain, and I can see why, actually. It's so huge. It's, wow. I don't... How do you do stuff like that? That's amazing. That is quite impressive. Okay then. Right, so this is absolutely huge. I am excited to have a go at this. Wow. This is a cool looking little buggy. There we go. So one needs to lock us down at all times. And we need to turn with the track. Oh wow, look at this. Wow, that's fantastic. I can't believe this actually works so well. Oh, see the tracks actually changed then. The tracks automatically changed as we went around it. That, what a wonderful piece of design. Well, now a scrap mechanic really does need to add curved blocks to the game, because this would be a lot easier for people to make if it had smooth curved edges. And nope, too fast over that. Okay then. Pretty fun, but not what we really want. So I need to put thrusters on down constantly. And A round. Now watch this track turn. Watch it reset. Look at that. How brilliant is that? Right, so we need to thrust with these corners here. We certainly get some speed up on this. So we need to be really careful up here now. When we get to the top, we need to slow right down. Easy does it. Okay, and just take it slow. There we go. Brilliant. I love it. Okay, and through the mouth. That's going to work. Oh, no! We're stuck. And we're at the start again. Wow. This is so impressive. And up the big ramp. Oh, can't see what's happening. Oh, can't see what's happening. I cannot see a thing. This is a bit scary. Okay, so we're over the top. Nearly. Yeah. Taking it slowly. Easy does it, easy does it. Oh, that's kind of scary, actually. So brilliant. Oh, wow. Well, now that is impressive. That was just awesome. Ingenious. I can't even imagine how long that took to build. Okay, so as a final thing we're going to have a look at now, it's a bit different of anything that I've ever looked at before, and it's just simply a house, or a mansion. It looks pretty cool, very well done. Modern mansion with 246 lights by IKEA07. This is looked like a bit of a labour of love, someone that obviously really does enjoy architecture and wanted to see how far they could push scrap mechanic in that area. Now, this is a big build again. Oh, it's loaded pretty fast, and I don't want to get stuck under this house, so how am I going to do this now? Maybe a little. Run really fast. No! Okay, so I don't know how I'm going to do this now. No! Okay, then. I am a little bit confused as to what I'm going to do here. I'm so sorry. There we go. That's better. Right. Oh, look at that. So, I think we're at the front door anyway. Let's take a step back and have a little look. Wow. Really nice. I feel like we need a car to go park in this garage, though. Okay, so I've built some step up here, so hopefully I can just drive up this into my garage. It's my beautiful home. Oh, little bit anxious, little bit too keen there. There we go. Look at that. Oh, it's very, we got just a bright spot there. Okay. No. Don't try that at home. Imagine if that's how you got into your garage every day. The lights. Oh, wow. Look at that. It's a lot of lights. There we go. So the automatic, but then you've got to run through as fast as you can before the door squishes you in half. Okay, and through. Nope, nope. it's a nice feature, but I'm not sure. I think it needs a little bit of work. Okay, and run. Okay, right, nice. This is the automatic Hal House trying to kill me. Got a kitchen here, and another switch. Wow. We've got an outdoor fresco eating area, a lovely pool with bridge. Not quite an infinity pool, but how do you... Is it water? Nope. It's glass. Must be very cold out, I think that's what it is. Frozen pool at the moment with a jacuzzi spa area, some lovely sun loungers. Yes, makes sense. I guess it can get cold at night. So we've got outdoor steps going up to the balcony. So I'm guessing this is... so this is the landing as we go up the stairs. Some nice seating area, a huge bath. Little ducky. We have an office. There's pictures and... This guy's obviously obsessed with radios. I think they're meant to look like filing cabinets. So this is the bedroom. It's a very big bedroom to be one, just one bedroom house. Very big house, to be just one bedroom. Okay, I think that's actually everything. So that's an absolutely beautiful creation. It makes me hope that there's stuff like this in the main game once it finally comes out. It would be cool to walk around houses and stuff. Maybe there's not just fields and farms, maybe there's streets as well and homes and stuff. I mean, that would be pretty cool. Well, one fantastic creation, and I think we're going to leave it there for now. I've got lots of more creations to show, and I'll be doing another video very soon. So I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you again.